It's a no ball. It's going out of the ground. It's huge. It's six. That was straight out of the middle of the batter. No ball from Shane Bott. And Christopher Gayle is in astounding form.
This is an imperial shot. Picked up the line very early. And he hardly looked to hit it at all. It's just in such fluency. Is absolutely tremendous.
In the air, could be uncaught. He's dropped it. It's all happening at the moment. Mark Richardson, who almost took Christopher Gayle at the other end of the ground, the riverside, has dropped him at mid-on.
Now, this is, I suppose, you have to take these. It's easy enough. It was just dropping in front of him.
So that West Indies total pushed along at a fair old clip by Christopher Gayle, who took full toll on the new ball, in fact being taken by Stephen Fleming a few overs just before tea. The sessions were for the West Indies. Two wickets lost, 105 runs scored.
Flicked away, very fine, that's gone very quickly for four. Leg lance employed by Chanderpaul. Ends off the over, 281 for four. Cut away by Chanderpaul. It's short and wide, and on this type of pitch, that's asking to be hit for four, which it was. 286 for four. Drive down the ground by Chanderpaul. He gets hold of this one. No great flourish in the shot. Long chase for the long off. They'll come back for three. Pulled away by Chanderpaul. That's a long hop. Raises yet another 50 partnership for the West Indies. And going back and just standing up straight, hammering down the ground. And will go all the way. Really a powerful man, Chris Gayle. Didn't seem to have timed that at all.
Didn't drag it from outside off stump. Perhaps was looking to get it a little bit square.
My goodness. Ooh. Mid-off was no more than a couple of yards away from that. And he hardly moved before the ball had passed him.
Well, the mid-off didn't even get down, Tony. Couldn't even get into a stride. It was struck so powerfully. The mid-on just about, mid-off just about to take off. And it was gone.
Chanderpaul has gone after him, however. Locked him over mid-on, and that's gone for four. Not a characteristic Chanderpaul shot, but effective. Fair straight drive, that brings up his 150. Good save by Vettori. 151 for Chris Gayle, as the over ends with the West Indies 311 for four.
And that's hard, high, one bounce over the boundary, four runs. Beautiful shot. Again, he really had to use the strength of the wrist to get that ball away. Vettori suffering again. And they might be in need of some therapy here, the New Zealand bowlers, because that's four more. The deficit now just 41. Daniel Vettori has taken some stick. More power, more runs. It really has been the order of the day. Daniel Vettori probably doesn't even know where his next wicket is coming from.
And that's going to go all the way to the boundary. Struck with another dose of firm power. And even the diving effort could stop it. Good shot again from Chris Neal. It's gone through. Matt Horn diving at him. Couldn't get a hand to it. Runs into the boundary markings. Speaking of volcanic, that is an eruption once again from Chris Gayle. Almost running out of ways to describe this innings.
Slower ball, one of the off cutters that Scott Styris bowled so well. But Chris Gayle equals at the task. Oh, he struck that beautifully.
He's got that through. Probably doesn't have the legs to make it all the way to the boundary, but certainly they'll pick up three. Good piece of timing from Chanderpaul.
Who's to 199? Crowd anticipating this double 100 for Gayle. There's a tremendous atmosphere around the ground, as it tends to be at all West Indian grounds when the West Indies are doing as well as this. Almost a one-day atmosphere. This ground is packed for the first one-day internationals it's had. It had five. Driven back down the ground, a no ball. And timed sweetly enough that it will go all the way for four. Sends the West Indies into the lead by three. And dropped. Hit very hard to the left of the diving fielder at cover. Matt Horn, the substitute, on for Craig McMillan. It was travelling. He had to fly through the air to get the left hand to it, but he did get the hand to it and put it down.
New Zealand have had to wait a long time for chances. Diving effort from Matthew Horn to his left. Hit powerfully by Gayle. Only got the left hand to it, had it spilled from there. Still on 199.
That's it. Crowd rises and cheers. Waves and jumps and shouts, and Gayle will come back for the second. Spectators are coming onto the ground to hail Chris Gayle's double 100.